Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2251, Pivot Table Icons. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, you know what? I travel around the country doing these seminars all the time, and we talk about doing pivot tables. We'll create a little pivot table here. And I always say that when someone is brand new to pivot tables, it seems really intimidating, and one of the reasons it seems intimidating is because of the pivot table field list over here. And that if I could get the keys to building 36 on the Microsoft campus for just an hour, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and I'm going to change this word columns and this word rows in the pivot table field list. Instead of columns, I'm going to say the field you want across the top of your report. And here, the word rows is going to say the stuff you want down the side of your report. And instead of sigma values, maybe the things you want to add up. Right, but here's the other thing that's really odd about this, and this is only going to make sense if you've been using pivot tables for a long, 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 long time. Take a really close look at this icon here for columns. Columns means it's the fields that are going to go across the top of the report. That icon that you see, that icon is not the columns icon. That icon is the icon that belongs down here in rows, because that's where the dark gray part is. And then here, this icon for rows is really the icon for columns, right? So I keep imagining that some summer intern built this dialog box and put the wrong icon there, and they put it there years ago. I mean, it's been wrong in Excel 2013 and Excel 2016 and everything. And this eventually bugged me so much that I actually wrote a letter, not an email, an actual letter, and I mailed it off to the Excel team, and with no response, no response at all, until a couple weeks ago when the guy on the Excel team said, "Hey, Bill." He sent me an email. He says, "Bill, I've been on sabbatical." Sabbatical? What is this? You don't show up to work for 6 months? He says, "Yeah, I've been on sabbatical and I just got back and your letter's here on my desk." And gosh, you're right. It's wrong. We'll have to fix it. All right, now, so I tell this story because it's going to be fixed, and you know, it's a good chance to get a laugh. You know, at 11 o'clock in the morning, we've been talking about Excel for 2 or 3 hours, and I was in Appleton, Wisconsin. Appleton, Wisconsin. Tiny little town here. Let's take a look at Appleton and we'll figure out. We can find out about Appleton using the card here. So it's up in central Wisconsin, population 74,000. I was there at a big company doing a seminar, and I, you know, I made this joke again, and someone in the audience says, no, wait a second. Those icons are exactly right. And I'm like, what? What do you mean they're exactly right? And I said, well, look at it. It's not showing where the field's going to go. This is actually a garden hose. And the garden hose for columns is spraying the data along the top of the report. So when you take product there, it's going to spray those product labels across the top. And this one is a garden hose pointing down, so that's why it takes the data and points down. And I was very amused with that result, because that's crazy. That's not the way it is. And if you want proof, I know I don't need to prove this to you, but if I come in here to field pivot table options and go to display and classic pivot table layout. That's when we can actually drag fields around the report. So I take the product field and I come over here to drag. You see that icon right there, the dark part is the area along the left hand side where we're about to drop the field. And up here in the columns area, it's the dark parts along the top. So very clearly those two icons over there are reversed. Now normally I guess you would go to excel.uservoice.com and try and pitch this, but it worked with a letter, and I'm starting to be convinced that a letter is the right way to go with the Excel team, because you know, we used to have this other problem that if you had a blank cell in the middle of your data and you created a pivot table from that, insert pivot table, put it in an existing worksheet, click OK, and normally if I would choose product and rep and then drag sales here, we would get a count instead of a sum, but you see, we're now getting a sum. This has been broken for years, and then just suddenly just got fixed in May of 2018. You know, I sent an email out to the Excel team. I said, "Hey, you know, what's the story here?" "No, there's no story. We didn't fix anything." "Well, no, clearly you fixed something. It's been broken forever." So they looked again, and again, someone sent a letter, and the letter said, "You know, hey, you're treating this blank cell as if it's text. It's not text. It's just a blank cell. You shouldn't treat the blank cells as text. Treat it like zero, like any formula." I would treat that, you know, if we just had a formula here that pointed to that cell, it's going to be zero. So a blank cell should be treated as zero. And whoever it was on the Excel team that got that letter said, "Yeah, you're right." And they just fixed it. So this thing that's been driving us crazy for years, now completely fixed. All right, so there you go. It's Friday. Thought you'd enjoy a couple of little little items there. Next time you create a pivot table, or you're trying to teach someone how to create a pivot table, just notice that those are wrong. And if someone wants to know what it is, it's just a garden hose spraying data across the top or down the right hand side. Thanks to Nicole in Appleton for that awesome little analogy there. Well, hey, to learn everything about pivot tables, check out my book, Power Excel with Mr. Excel. Click that I in the top right hand corner. Wrap up for today. The icons for rows and columns in the pivot table field list are backwards, and they've been backwards for quite some time, unless I have it all wrong, and it's really a garden hose spraying data across the top of the report. Thanks to Nicole and Appleton for that memory aid. Also, two other things you saw today: classic pivot table layout, and then blank cells in the revenue or sales column no longer cause a count instead of a sum. So thanks to the Excel team for continually fixing these issues. To download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL in the YouTube description. If you like this video, please click like down there. It makes a difference. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.